Amen. Amen, everyone. Okay, if you guys can turn your videos on, it always helps me to see your beautiful faces as we have our worship. I want to remind you, that TCKs, anyone, remnants, as we start our worship, are ones who have been given the blessing to see in advance. And although it might not be happening right now, I just want to remind you also that the gospel, despite what a lot of the mainstream Christianity will tell you, is not something that you have to do. Even seeing in advance or doing world evangelization, it's not something that you have to do. Yes, God is going to do it through you, but the gospel doesn't work that way. And that's the beauty of how God works. He has finished everything. That's what the gospel is. It's done completely. The debt that we owe, paid. The enemy that we were connected to, his work destroyed. Completely severed from him, connection to him, although he's still trying to work. But that complete work of Christ is finished. Okay, and that's the absolute covenant, the C from the CVDIP that you need to hold on to. God's vision of world evangelization, he's going to do. He promises to do it through you. And the way that's going to take place is that vision of God, absolute vision of God, becoming yours. And that's when it becomes your dream. And seeing that dream ahead of time, like even though if it's not happening right now, you know, there's things. Seeing that sure covenant and vision fulfilled in your life ahead of time in advance is what is called dream. Putting it into your dream, making it yours. The image and practice comes and follows from that. You'll see that it is indeed true that God is with you. He's going to use you. And you start to see that, which is image, the 25, the working of the kingdom of God. You start to taste little by little. Worship is a very important key in tasting that. When you have worship, you kind of feel that. You might not feel like that all the time, but when you worship together, you can start to experience a little bit, taste it. Like, oh man, God is alive. He's with me. He's going to use me. And the practice, the fulfillment of that absolute covenant is absolutely going to take place. I know all of you are saying amen deep in your hearts and souls and spirits, although we can't open the mics. You can, you know, for youth service, I think the mics, you can turn the mics on or off. It doesn't really matter because most of you guys are respectful. The children have a harder time sitting still and keeping quiet, but you can turn the mics on as long as there's no background noise. You're not at a cafe or somewhere. You're in a quiet place. And if you want to say amen, you can say amen and let everyone hear you. But here we go. Let me show you guys the PPT. Okay, so today's topic today is children of the devil, right? It's a very important topic. The three organizations, and we'll talk about a little bit of detail about that as well. But the three organizations and Satan, using those three organizations, religious organizations, all trying to focus on not revealing, not knowing the real creator God, or saying that there is no God, that you yourselves are God. But as we have heard in the past couple weeks, we know that God had made us to be with him, that we're created to be with God. We're happiest when we're enjoying God, because that's how we're created. We're created as spiritual beings, okay? And spiritual beings made in God's image are created to know God and worship him and enjoy him. That's the way that we are created to be. Fish in water, you guys have heard this message before. Birds in the sky, trees in the ground. But you really need to personalize this and make this real. Nothing on this earth is going to make you happy. Everything, you know, I hear a little bit of background noise. Let me just mute everybody, okay? But everyone is created to enjoy That's what human beings are. So anything else is a false sense of happiness. Yes, things make you happy. Money, if you have a money, it makes you happy. But everything that's being taught to you by your peers and by the culture, it's a false happiness. Yeah, if you look good, you have a good image, you know, you're popular, you have this, you have that. Yeah, it's going to give you a sense of confidence, but that's a false sense of confidence because you're not created to be happy fully with those things alone. I'm not saying those things aren't needed. Not at all. Don't get me wrong. All those things are needed. But what you really need is to enjoy God. Why? Because that's how we're made. Okay, that's how we're made. So I know I showed this picture on Wednesday TZK day, but yeah, see that dog right there? Is that dog really praying? No, he's been trained to pray. Maybe getting a few snacks and he's, you know, looks like he's praying, but he's not praying. Mankind is the only thing in creation that worships God, that seeks God, that prays, in other words. Okay, because we're spiritual beings. Okay. And we talked about this last week. Does that mean that we always need to close our eyes and raise our hands? And we talked about heaven. When you get to heaven, what are you going to do? We're going to worship God, right? Amen. But a lot of people think that that's what we're going to do 24/7. Oh my gosh, Pastor Sam, aren't our hands going to be tired? Like, how are we going to do that forever? Aren't our voices going to be tired? Guys, the kingdom of God and enjoying God is everything. It's not just closing your eyes and praising God with your voices. It's everything that you do. Remember that. So whatever you eat or drink, whatever you do, do it all for the glory of God. If you're enjoying the gospel, everything becomes worship. Amen. Even eating, even studying, even playing sports, even taking leisure, right? Remember the Garden of Eden, Adam and Eve before the fall, before original sin, everything was worship, guys. Everything was created for God, by God, for us to enjoy through Him. Through Him. When they ate the fruits of the tree, of all the trees in the garden, it was worship. It was enjoying God. It was 24 enjoying God. Jeez, guys, I bless you guys in Jesus' name. You understand what I'm saying? You know, you don't have to separate these things. The kingdom of God is upon you, the remnants. Amen. Restore that original identity, that image. So when you study, it's not, oh, I'm studying, I can't worship God. I'm studying, I can't pray. No, that's such a limitation in what the kingdom of God is, right? That's not how we're recreated, okay? Everything is for you to enjoy God, okay? Now, don't misunderstand. That doesn't mean, okay, that means I can, you know, I'll play 10 hours of video games straight and I'm worshiping God. That doesn't mean that either. It doesn't mean that everything that you do all the time worships God. But what I'm saying is everything that you do, it can be a worship to God if you're enjoying the gospel. If you have the mindset of the gospel, you have the vision of the gospel, the eyes of the gospel, even doing dishes worships God. I experience that daily. Well, I used to. Now my kids are experiencing that. But everything becomes worship, okay? So what, something happened to this relationship, right? Everything was perfect. Everything was enjoyment, 24. But something happened. Satan tempted man. Man sinned and all the problems began. We know this very well, and you guys have to personalize this message. Last week was, you know, trying to find and understand the root. The root of that is the covenant of works, right? The Lord God commanded the man. He commanded man, Adam and Eve, not to eat of the fruit of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. On the day you shall eat of it, you shall surely die. God gave man a command. Why did he do that? Because he loves man. Remember that, right? A lot of skeptics, maybe your friends, a lot of people who don't understand correctly the covenant, they ask this question and say, is God playing a game? What's up with that? Why the tree? Why even the option? Because he loves us. Because we're created in his image. He gave mankind a choice. There's the door. I create you in my image. I give you everything. I'm everything. I give you myself. My image is in you. But you know what? If you don't want that, there's the door. There can be no love if there's no choice. So there it is. And how, what do we know? We know Satan came. Did God know that Satan was going to do this? Absolutely. Right? Before the creation of the world, he had a solution for this problem. But this is the start of the problem. It's very important that we understand. Satan comes to the woman and says, hey, did God say you can't have any fruit? That's what Satan does today too. Does God want you not to have any fun? Does not God want you not to eat anything? That's the same card that Satan will play. Oh, Christianity is boring. Let me sacrifice. It's hard work, and man, you have to follow so many rules, and man, do you want to be Christian really? That's what his lie is. Remember what true Christianity is: enjoying God, your creator, right? Enjoying true happiness. I know all of you are saying amen, amen, amen. But Satan comes and says, no. That's Christianity is not supposed to be fun. Not supposed to be fun. It's supposed to be hard work. No. And the woman said to the serpent, we may eat of the fruit of the trees in all the garden. But God said, she adds a word and she removes a word. Remember? She heard the covenant from Adam, not directly from God. If you look in Genesis 2. And she adds a word. She adds a word touch. And she removes the word surely. And then the devil, taking that opportunity, puts the word surely back in. Do you see that in verse 4? You will not surely die. With the lie, he puts surely back in. Eve removes it. The devil puts it back in. And says, God knows that when you eat of it, he's lying to you. Guys, you're not going to die. You're not going to surely die. You're going to be like God. That's the same thing, the same point that the devil is using today. Right, so what happened was, instead of trusting God, Adam and Eve, instead of trusting God, they believed the lie of Satan. The devil's the father of lies, and they believe his lie and chose, I want to be like God. Okay, and after this event, what happened? Everyone after that original sin is now tainted with that sin. Okay, for there is no one righteous, not even one, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Guys, you guys have to wrap your entire minds around this, right? Some people say that it's unfair. Some people are going to say that. You guys might even be thinking that. What's up with that? Adam made the mistake. Why is it on me? And I'm telling you right now, guys, if you really think about this, you really think about it deeply. It's such good news that that's the way it is. Right? We talked about this last week too. If Adam didn't blow up for everyone, by the way, he's the most perfect human being in all of history because he didn't have sin until he sinned. But if Adam doesn't blow up for everyone and it's up to us, oh my God, that's bad news, guys. Because that means you have to do it. Who's good then? How do you know? How do you know if you're good enough? How do you know if you've done enough? Who's righteous? Are you? Am I? I don't know. But that's what religion is, guys. The Bible is not talking about religion. The frame the Bible is putting out is absolute. Every single human being born after Adam and Eve's original sin is born underneath sin. There's no way, there's no human, there's no one. There are great people in this world, but none that are righteous on their own. Okay? It takes a sense of honesty. And the reason why this is so hard to admit is because we're ingrained with Genesis 2. We had the ability to be righteous at one time. We want to be good. We want to be right. We want to be righteous. So when someone puts us down, we feel bad. When someone says, no, you're not, you feel like, what? I have bad words coming out of my mouth and in my mind, I won't say them. But you know, that's our attitude normally. Like, come on, man, you're full of yourself. Don't tell me that. We feel defensive. Why? Because we're wired to be want to be good. But the Bible's saying, no, there's no one that's good, not even one. Israel, the Jews got it wrong. They thought that God wanted them to keep the law, to be righteous. God wants us to keep the law because follow the law because that's what it means to be holy, but we can't keep it perfectly. It's not meant to be kept to be righteous. Romans chapter 3, verse 20 of the same chapter. The law is not given for you to keep it and be righteous, but rather to be conscious of sin, to realize that you're a sinner. It's not just that we're separated from God, guys, because of original sin. Now, here's today's me message point. You belong to your father, the devil, and you want to carry out your father's desire. It's pretty serious. It's not just separation from God, it's connection to Satan. Okay? He's our father. Let me show you a picture. This is what the children saw this morning to explain. Okay? If you have a daddy bear and a mommy bear, what do you get? A baby bear. You don't get a dog, a cat. That's what, okay, we won't get into that, but that's what evolutionists believe. You get a bear 100 times out of 100 times. Daddy lion, mommy lion, what do you get? A baby lion. Daddy duck, mommy duck, what do you get? A baby duck. Daddy elephant, mommy elephant, what do you get? Baby elephant, and so on. Daddy monkey, mommy monkey, you get baby monkey. Daddy human, mommy human, of course, that's me and Deborah, you get baby human. Those are my kids. They look like us, yeah? Naturally. Now check this out. Daddy sinner, mommy sinner, baby sinner. He who does what is sinful is of the devil because the devil has been sinning from the beginning. Guys, we broke the law and we break the law. That means we sin. Okay, the wages of sin is death. Not only is the wages of sin death, that puts us under Satan's dominion. It's a closer relationship than you think. People that are sinners think that, oh, I'm a good person, I'm a bad person. Okay, I have a sin. I have sin. I'm a bad, that means I'm a sinner. I'm a bad person sometimes. That's what they think. But that's not where it stops. They're connected to Satan. This is so serious. So Jesus didn't just come to pay for our sin. A lot of mainstream Christianity, all they talk about is the blood of Jesus and he just came to forgive us of our sins. Yes, that's one of the offices of Christ. But he comes as our king to destroy the work of Satan. Why do people go to hell? Does God send people to hell? I'm mean, try to illustrate just a little bit so you guys can understand a little bit more. I used to think that I was like, is that fair? Is God sending people to hell? And Matthew 25:41 says that God created hell for Satan. It's Satan's prison. I used to think, in the cartoons, that Satan was like the king of hell, like, ha, I am the king. And like everyone comes and they're all like worshiping him. And no. Satan's not the king of hell. That's his prison. He hates that place. He doesn't want to go there. That's where he's going to be locked up for eternity. But why do people go to hell? It's not because that they're bad. God doesn't send bad people to hell. If bad people go to hell, we all go to hell. God doesn't take good people to heaven. Bad people don't go to hell, guys. People go to hell because that's where their father is. We go to heaven not because we're good. We are made good and righteous by the blood of Jesus, but we go to heaven because that's where our father is. Do you guys understand? That's how serious the problem is, okay? There's a verse again. You belong to your father, the devil, and you want to carry out your father's desire. He is a liar and the father of lies. Everything out of his mouth is a lie. So the biggest lie that he's going to give is the focus he's going to try to do is to have you focus on yourself. That's the only power that he has to deceive you, because you, created in God's image, have so much power. He's going to try to twist your thoughts and steal your heart. He can't touch your spirit because it's paid for and done. Right? You crossed over from death to life. But he is going to try to steal your hearts and your minds to help you, make you focus on yourself. To want what's only best for you. To be very self-centered. To think and want to be like God. Not giving God control, you trying to get control. Instead of seeking out what God desires, wanting what you desire, what's best for your life right now. And what God is saying, what's best for you is to enjoy him. Okay, and the devil's going to try everything so that you guys will ignore that. He's going to try everything so that you guys would not focus on him, would not focus on the God inside of you, but rather be driven by your own will, be driven by your own emotions, your own desires. This is what's going to make me happy. But God is telling you what's going to make you happy is him, himself. And he's given himself to you. Okay, and I want to make it real, a little bit more real to you, show you a few more pictures. The world, the way that Satan works, it's in a way that's so disguised at times, and it sometimes looks so beautiful. Okay, that's his strategy. He's an angel of light, okay? And you got to see this in advance. The age that's coming, guys, in this world today, that's self-centered, that's beyond self-centered, it's making man into gods. Into gods. The New Age message isn't, you know, hey, worship this idol or this god or, you know, Buddha or whatever. It is to find the God inside of you. You have the power, the mystery, the energy. The universe is inside of you. Use that power to attain whatever, your dream or your destiny, exactly, whatever. It's such a beautiful message, but this is a message that is going to cause greater and greater problems. Artificial intelligence is going to reinforce that. Man creating, quote unquote, life intelligence. You think that's far away? It's right around the corner. It's already happening. And more people are going to suffer spiritually, and they're not going to know why. They're not going to know why. And let me show you a few pictures, okay? The New Age message is you can be like God. Some of you, I don't know if anyone here has been with me to Thailand, but this is what's called the Dhammakaya Buddhist religion. Doesn't it kind of look like a UFO? Transcendental meditation's roots come from Hinduism and meditation from Buddhism. But this organization, if you're wondering what that UFO is made up of, it's made up of over 10 million miniature Buddha statues. And each of those statues has a name on it. And each of those names, it costs money to put your name on it. And this is one of the fastest growing Buddhist religions, Buddhist organizations in the world, all striving for world peace. But a couple years ago, I took a bunch of remnants as we went to Karen. There's Pastor Brett in the background. Some of you know Pastor Brett. We took the actual temple is so big, you have to take like a Disneyland tram type thing to get there. And that's us in front of that thing. And let me show you how big the complex is. That complex is so wide that they can fit 1 million people at one time. It's like Mecca in Buddhism. Okay. But this stream, this flow is happening all over the world. It's called TM. It's happening in schools. It's happening in workplaces. People are taught to meditate and to find the God that's inside of them. Now, if that was true, if the Bible wasn't true, then that'd be great. But what they're tapping into, the power that they're tapping into is not God, it's another spirit. And they're receiving power and they're receiving things from that. So you guys see this as the strategy of Satan. It's very, very serious. And one of the most famous people to be the spokesman of TM is, you, I don't know, younger guys might know, but might not know, but one of the most powerful women in the world is Oprah Winfrey. And about 10 years ago, she came across a town in Iowa. This is in the United States. One entire town has two of these meditation centers, and pretty much the whole town comes and meditates every day. The basic message is, you don't need God. You can be like God. Okay. You have the power of God inside of you. In fact, the more and deeper you go in, they say you are God. The reason why the Son of God appeared was to destroy the devil's work. Okay, the main work of the devil is that, it's just like in Genesis 3, was to cause disbelief. Jesus comes to destroy his work. Okay, let me give you this last passage before we close. This is Isaiah 53. He was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was a chastisement that brought us peace. And with his wounds, we are healed. We like sheep have gone astray. We have turned every one of us to his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. Like a lamb that is led to slaughter, and like a sheep that is before his shearers is silent, so he opened not his mouth. Okay. He didn't open his mouth. He didn't say a word. And just like a sheep led to slaughter, God, in the form of man, Jesus Christ, paid the debt that we owe on the cross. And he didn't stay dead, right? He rose from the dead. He walked out of the tomb, destroying the work of Satan, giving us that victory now. Amen? So today, when you have forum, really meditate upon these two verses, John 8:44 and 1 John 3:8. And these three prayer topics. Help me see how Satan controls people, controls the world. Think about culture and how he's doing that. Help also have forum on how Satan tricks me. What are some of the strategies that he uses against me so that I won't know, enjoy God? Help me to know that Jesus destroyed the work of the devil. Let me pray. Heavenly Father, thank you, Lord, so much for your grace in destroying the work of Satan. Father, I pray that this gospel message would be deeply rooted in all of our TCKs, in all of us, Lord, so that we may be thoroughly equipped to share this absolute good news to the world. Help us first, Lord, to personalize it and enjoy it. Bless our time of form as well. We thank you and pray these things in Jesus' wonderful name. Amen.